Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul.
Pastor Dr. Lawson Ngua is the General Overseer of Sunrise Banner Bible Church worldwide, with international headquarters in Abuja, Nigeria. Pastor Dr. Lawson Ngua is commissioned by God to provide the ministry of the Word of God and to disciple the whole world through the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. Sunrise Banner Bible Church, we believe in God, we believe what God says.
You for your faithfulness. I'm counting on you for what you did before. I know that if you do that before, you can do this again today. I'm counting on you for your greatness. You expose yourself and you introduce yourself to a man called Joshua. And so I know that if you do that to Joshua, you do that to Moses, it's possible you can do same to me. And so, Father, this I know that today I'm counting on you. And I'm counting on you for a good news in the name of Jesus. And then, Lord, I pray that you give good news to everyone hearing my voice today. You give good news to everyone hearing my voice today. There'll be a good news at the back. There'll be a good news on my right. There'll be a good news on my left. There'll be a good news at the overflow. There'll be a good news in the name of Jesus. I'm counting on and I'm counting on God. And so, Lord, I believe you that as many in this service right now, and as many connected to this service right now, I declare, oh God, that as we keep counting on you, miracles everywhere in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father, for answering our prayers. Speak to your church today. For Jesus' wonderful name, we pray. You're going to give me a very wonderful amen before you sit down. No. I can see young, vibrant people in this place. Can I hear another amen again? You can please be seated. I come to Joshua chapter 1. In the book of Joshua chapter 1, I'm still in verse 1 and verse 2. I look at Joshua chapter 1 and verse 2. It says, now, after the death of Moses, the servants of the Lord, it came to pass that the Lord spake unto Joshua, the son of Nun, Moses' minister, saying, Moses, my servant, is dead now. After your desires are dead now. After all your plans are dead now. You can count on God now. After all your plans are dead now. After the man you depend on thinking he was going to marry you fail now. After the woman you depend on fails now. After everything you have tried fails now. The Bible says, now therefore, arise, go over this Jordan. Thou and all these people, there is a prophecy here is not just him. It is you and your entire family will cross over the Jordan. Can I hear you again? Mind you, today, nobody is allowed to give me any local amen. I said, nobody is allowed to do what? No local amen here. So can I hear another amen again? I'll be watching you because today, and this study is a prophetic study. And every word that comes from my mouth, you will take it with all amount of seriousness. I may not say it the way you want to hear it, but as the word comes forth, for he sent forth his word, and that word did something in their lives. He heals them. And as the word comforts your life today, you take that word with almost all amount of seriousness in Jesus' name. Look at verse 2 again. Moses, my servant, is dead. At that time, even people who are servants of God feel. There are times when even people who has all the destiny died also. But do you know there is a good news for you today? Every spirit of deadness, what has killed your destiny, killed your glory, killed your joy, that thing resurrects now. I said that thing resurrect now in the name of Jesus. We're looking at the message today. Write it down. Let me spell it so that you will get it right. W I S H B O M for Nigeria. E. What did you call that? Eh? Say it again. Which bone? Now take the next one. B. U. T. What did you call that? Say it again. Now take the next one. M, that is M for Nigeria. O, what did you call that? Say it again. Take the next one. B, A, C, K, B, O, N, E. Say it again. Come on, say it again. So, can we pronounce all now after two, one, go? Say it again. Can I hear you again? There are witches everywhere. People witch things every day. Witch bone, but no backbone. What helps you to succeed in life is the backbone, not the witch bone. As you go around the world today, you're going to be seeing people wants to be a graduate, but not many of them want to sit down in the classroom. You're going to see people who wishes to be like this person, but how many of them want to walk the way that person walk? I got to a place some time ago, and after the speech, And then over 80% of the people that were seated in that conference say, Father, we want to be like you. But how many of them we want to labor the way I labored? How many of them we want to think the way I think? How many of them want to study the way I studied? How many of them want to put their passion as a drive to their vision? How many of them we want to allow their passion to supersede their interest? You know, it's easy for one to be born with an interest, with a passion, but when the worldly interest come, it can fight that passion and turn you upside down. Now, as you look at Joshua, you are going to see a man with wishbone plus backbone. You're going to see a man who wishes to be a leader and also develop the passion and the backbone to be a leader. And until you have people like that in ministry, in family, in Nigeria, in the world, you're never going to have anything. Look at the Bible now. Let's look at Deuteronomy chapter 1. Deuteronomy chapter 1. Open your Bible to Deuteronomy chapter 1 in verse 38. But Joshua, the son of Nun, which standeth before thee, he shall do what? My friend, I'm not hearing you. He shall do what? As at this time, was he a leader? As at this time, was he the one leading the children of Israel? But God knew that they have the backbone to go. And then look at it here. He shall go in either. Now, look at the next word. Encourage him. For he shall cause Israel to do what? Inherit it. As you come to the church, and as you have leaders in the ministry, and as you have people in the ministry, there is something we need to understand. Because as you look straight on, it says, but Joshua, the son of Nun, withstanded before thee, he shall go. One, he was standing, he was not sitting. Pressure never threw him off balance. He was standing. He was standing in the faith. He wasn't a backslider. He wasn't rising and falling. He was standing all through the 40 years he was with Moses. He was standing. And so, for him to go is because he was standing. He wasn't a Christian today and a backslider tomorrow. He was standing. In fact, the leaders can say he is standing. And they say, encourage him, for he shall cause Israel to inherit it. You, today, God will develop a backbone in your life. My friend, I say God will develop a backbone in your life. Do you know why you need the backbone? Number one, because you need the power to say no. There are certain things you need to say no to. And until you have the backbone to say no, you will never say no. Do you know that there are people that fornication still deal with it tomorrow? In fact, each time they want to say no, they lack the power to say no to it. There are people lies still deal with. Each time they want to say no, they find it difficult to say no to it. There is no backbone at all to stand. There There are people who are still stealing. They're stealing. And in their mind, they don't want to be a criminal. They don't want to be a thief. But they find it difficult to leave it. There are smokers. They smoke every minute of the day. And it's not their wishes to be a smoker. They want to leave smoking, but they find it difficult to leave it. There are people who are drunkards, fighters, even some youths today, even some adults today are in court. The witch is to leave court, but they didn't have the backbone to leave. There are people also who are also in ministry. I mean, they're in a church. They knew it too well. Now that church where they are is not a church. They knew that that place is a club, because any church that will not take me to heaven is a club. It's not a church. Am I talking to you? If I will go to church, like I keep hearing from people today, when they come to see me, and some of them will tell me, look, I went to see a pastor. The pastor said, give me 15,000 first before you can see me. And then you need to fill form and pay 2,000 naira for form. And then you need to go through this to see a pastor. That is fake. Can I hear you say fake? That's fake. That's not a church. And if I am in a business quarter, and I already knew that where I am is not the place for my dream, I need a backbone to take me out of that place. I need to be able to stand and to look at the man eyeball to eyeball. I say, please, thank you, sir, for the time I've been with you. Now I need to go. But did you know what people say? They say, write letter and resign. The day you came to that church, did you write letter to enter there? Answer me, my friend. Eh? Why do I have to resign? Why? Why do I have to resign when I didn't write a letter to come in? You know, you are either having the backbone that takes you forward, or you have a weak bone that keeps you in the wilderness forever. Say, I am living wilderness today. Can I hear you again? Some has witches, others like Joshua has purpose. As we look at the life of Joshua, what helps him? Number one, he had purpose. Write it down, he has purpose. Two, he has purpose. Two, he has a backbone. Three, he has a witches that can turn things around. He has a witch that can turn things around. That is, his desire, his thought can turn things around. How? Now, as we look at the children of Israel, they died. The whole of the nation of Israel, many of them died in wilderness, still wishing to get into Canaan. They died believing they were going to get into Canaan, but they never get there. They had a witch bone, but no backbone. Joshua turned witches, turned his desire into lands. I pray that your desire, you will turn it into lands in Jesus' name. He desire, he says, there is still much land to possess. That was what he said when Moses was still alive. And he turned that desire into lands. People have been thinking, there are people here, you've been thinking to go to school for more than past 6-7 years ago. You've been thinking to leave that house. You've been thinking, in fact, there is a boy or a man or whatever name you call him, that kept you in the house, and he's saying, I'm going to marry you. And you'll be keeping that man there for maybe 5 years now, 3 years now, 4 years now. And you've not been able to have the backbone to tell the man, my friend, is over. Now I'm born again. And some too, also are women that they're in bondage to, and they've not been able to even look at the woman and say, please, you know, I love you, but I love myself than I love you. Because love as you love yourself. So you must qualify the love at the level of love for yourself. So if loving yourself cannot save your soul, then you don't love yourself. Praise the Lord. That is the problem of today's generation. When once they hear about sin, nobody say amen again. They are angry with pastors that preach against sins. And that is why you will die in your sins if you fail to repent. You need a man that will tell you the truth. For ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall do what? If you don't have the truth, will you be free? No way. I pray that the truth of this place will set you free in Jesus' name. If you are very angry with me, don't say amen. I say if you are very, very angry with me, don't say amen. I'm looking at your face and I'm catching some of you. As if you are very, very angry with pastor, don't say amen. How many of you will like this church to preach the truth? Even if you are pretending, still put that hand up. Support me. How many person is supporting me? The truth will set this generation free. Give me amen. Number two, the witches of Joshua torn into cities. The Bible says for a planned city. So, his desire progresses. Grow. And then number three, for time, is desire turned to homes. Number four is desires turned to possessions. What helped him to get that done? Number one is mind. The mind. His mindset was already made up. He had a mindset that we can take the land. I got into the land and I saw that the land flowed with what? Milk and honey. So his mindset was not like the mindset of his friends. They went there 12 in number. Only him and Caleb saw different things. Your mind will determine what you see. It is the eye of the mind that gives you results. If the eye of the mind is blind, then the eyes will be blind. Number two, the mouth. I can see the mouth of Joshua. His mouth speaks positive things. His mouth was not speaking negative things. His mouth was not busy saying, we see the Amalekite, we see the Penazite, we see the Zabusite, we see. No! His mouth says, it's possible I can succeed. That's the mouth. Anything you see on the mouth of a man That is what the mind have said. Take a child that will do well. He will talk well. Take a youth that will do well. He will talk well. Take a minister that will do well. He will talk well. Take a mother that will do well. She will talk well. Take a father that will do well. He will talk well. Number three, the moon. Now, as you look at Joshua, he was not saying, you know, please don't come near me now because my moon no good now. You know, there is a time I'm in a good moon. There is a time I'm not in a good moon. As you look at me now, I am very angry because I thought that this Moses would have handed over to me since. I've been waiting for him, even when God says, hand over, and the man has refused to hand over. Two, he would have planned a coup. But you never had any time that you hear that his moon was bad. He had a good moon. He had a joyful moon. His moment was always a good moment. Can I hear this? Just say amen. So as you look at this, Joshua, it's possible we can be living our life like him. Number four, attitude. Follow up on his attitude. You will see that his attitude made him. In fact, there is no life without attitude. Attitude is door opener. Attitude is what made anybody in life. Attitude can make you go further than your friends. As you look at the children of Israel, and as you look at all the trouble they were giving to Moses, you will never hear anywhere Joshua giving trouble to Moses. He had attitude. I pray that God will give this ministry attitude. Can I hear you say amen? God will give you attitude. If you have attitude in your family, you will be the first. If you have attitude in your home, you will be the first. And in fact, Jesus talked about it. He says, if you are faithful to that that is very little, then they need to give you more. That's attitude. In Matthew 25, open your Bible to Matthew 25. Please hurry up now. Matthew 25. And I'm going to read in verse 21. Matthew 25, verse 21. His Lord said unto him, well done, thou good and what? Faithful servant. He has attitude. He's a faithful servant. He has attitude. He says, thou good and faithful servant, thou art being faithful over a few things, I will make thee ruler over how many things now? Many things. Enter thou into the joy of thy, and what we believe and says, attitude will take you into the joy of your Lord. Amen again. Your attitude will give you an open doors in Jesus' name. Number six, he gets his mind back. I love this guy. He takes his mind back. Look, did you know why people fail today? They fail because they have failed to cast their mind back. Somebody asked me some time ago, he says, what is your secret that even as at whatever we tend to see in your life, we also see that you're very humble? What is the secret? The secret is because I look at my yesterday. If you can see your yesterday, you will live a good life. Am I talking to somebody? So many people doesn't look at yesterday. They all look at today. Yesterday gives you today, and today gives you tomorrow. If your tomorrow is fine, it's all because your yesterday was bad and that today was amended. If today is not amended, tomorrow will never be better. What makes tomorrow better is because there was an amendment today that works on your yesterday. And I'm praying that somebody here will work on his yesterday in Jesus' name. Can I also tell you something? How many times you fall does not matter. It's how many times you rise. People can fall. Nations can fall. That is like you fall before. But that doesn't matter. What matters is how many times have you risen. If you are falling before, and you're willing to rise today, you will rise and continue rising. What kind of people are these? Are you sure you really plan to go to church today? Are you sure? Eh? Okay, maybe we do the other pattern where I will call some of you to bring water for me here so that I can do like that. Say, everybody do pa wa 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 wa. Will you like that one? We should do that one. Okay, should we do this other time? Hey, and somebody say, a yeah. And they say, a yeah. Do we do that one? You're not going to make me like those small boys. Can I hear you say amen? Okay, me and them will get big voice, pass through. I for do one now. People are waiting for that before they say amen. It's a pity to this generation that we barely see men of God. Men of God are scarce. Servants of God are scarce. Laborers are scarce. But thank God, God has few. I say, God has what? Few. And if those few talks to you, you will value it. So can I hear you say amen again? Amen. Praise the Lord. I say praise the Lord. I know your life will never remain the same. When you look back, God will take you forward in Jesus' name. Oh my God. Let me run to point number one. I'm going to look at 3 points in this message. Point number one, the moment you go. Point number two, the man for Canaan. Point number three, the fight for freedom. Point number one, the moment you go. Nothing will happen until you develop the backbone to go. Check yourself. Even January this year, there were lists you write down. In fact, when they say cross overnight, even Juju, they go church that day. You go write down list. That is what we call wishbone. The bone that wishes. The bone that thinks, but no backbone. And then you go ride, you go fool everything. By January, I go do this. But after he finish writing that thing, he goes to his bedroom and sleep. Say, I know by God's grace, I know by God's grace, before March, I go, don't do my wedding. Work, you know, they look for nothing. He looks for absolutely nothing. He looks for no way to just move forward and get things done. No backbone to get things done. But all you see is, I will. 10 years. He's still telling you, I will. I pray that your story will change today. Open your mouth and say amen.
Amen.
If you look at Joshua, as soon as Moses died, the burial has never took place. They've not even buy casket. They've not even make burial arrangement. God said, my friend, now the man is dead. You arise and go. He had the backbone to tell the people, I am less go. And I'm wondering, who will do the burial? Joshua, you're not even going alone. You are going with the people that the great man of God has built up. When a servant of God died, you're not the one to do the burial. Angels does the burial. Oh my God. Heaven does the burial. Because the whole heaven is celebrating over a saint that come home. It does the burial. It's not how much will you bring. No. Heaven have a lot of sarin to blow. And so God tell Joshua, you has no business with this dead. This dead is the dead of heavens. Heaven will celebrate this dead. Oh my God, somebody here, heaven will celebrate you. It's not how many years you live on earth that counts. It's how well you live on earth. Even though I died today, they will still have one thing to say about me. I told people and I said, if I cannot carry this world on my head, I am going to give this world a little wound. On his body, so that anybody that will pass through this wall will see the crack. I say it was Pastor Lawson that gave this crack. You cannot pass through your world without giving your world a mark. You must say amen to that prayer before I continue. No devil will break your hand. I say, no, Satan will break your hand. So the moment you go, something will happen. Now, Jordan has been there for decades. And Jordan refused to part. Moses has also walked close to Jordan more than four times before he left. But Jordan never part. Why? Because when he was going there, none of the people followed him. They were interested in the manna. And so, when he said, can we go? They say, yeah, but there is food here. Yeah. Morning, they go and collect. Afternoon, they go and collect. Let me tell you, if you have somebody that give you free thing, every day free thing, it is time for you to go to that person and say, please, sir. Thank you for giving me free thing. It is time for me to move forward. The more free thing you collect, the more you are in bondage. Until you are able to change your step and say, no, I can also go forward and give to others. You can't go forward until you go forward from your head. The first thing that go forward is your thinking. Until the thinking go forward, the mind will not go forward. And until the mind go forward, the leg will not go forward. So going forward is not walking out of this hall. It is walking out of your lower mentality. I prophesied on somebody today. Your mental being will walk again. I say your mental being will walk again. In the name of Jesus. What helped Joshua to go forward? I gave you. Now, in Exodus, look at Exodus 24. Please, can I see people of God opening their Bible? Everywhere, please, can I see you opening your Bible? Exodus 24, in verse 13. In verse 13. And Moses rose up, and his minister Joshua. And Moses went up into the mount of God. As we look at that scripture, in verse 13, and Moses rose up, and his ministers were Joshua. So, as you look at this scripture, you are going to see that when God called Moses to go to the mount to pray, where he received the first five books of the law, he took with him who? Joshua. But as you look at the whole journey, even for the 40 days that Moses was there, the name of Joshua was not mentioned. His name wasn't mentioned, but he was there. The scripture told us he was there. But his name was not mentioned. And as I look at that, I saw, let me put it, five things that I saw in his life. Number one, Joshua went to the extra mile. He went to the extra. If you look at him, he just decided to follow Moses anywhere he goes to. If his name was not mentioned, who gave him food? How did he eat? Was he complaining? Was he murmuring? If it was some of us today, what we would have done is to say, Moses, please, I think it's time for you to stand up. We need to go back. Since you bring me here, you're not talking about anything about my food. Can we do a little bit of eating, Moses? Can we do a little bit of eating? His mind was there. His whole being was there. So number two, I saw what I call the mastermind. He has a mind of a master. Oh my God. No man can be a master until you develop a mastermind. You know, but what you see today is people want to be a master. In fact, if they have their way, they want to push somebody down and take over, but they don't have the mind, the mastermind. The mastermind can stay hungry while others eat. The mastermind can give his lifeblood for the journey to work. Everybody cannot be a master until you develop the mastermind. I pray God will give you the mastermind. Oh my God, you don't understand. I say I pray my God is given to you now the mastermind. I tell you a little thing. What I meant when I say mastermind. When I came to this Abuja, the Lord told me, please, it is time for you to go to Abuja. And I left for Abuja. And when I got here, I didn't have a house or wherever to stay. And I was like 2 years or 2 years plus back or 3 years now, plus or minus 3 years. And so, I was living in a hotel, and the money finished. When the money finished, I told the hotel, please, I think I need to go. So I picked up my bag, I went to Gwagolada, and I went into that Gwagolada primary school and started living there, was sleeping there. So if day breaks in the morning, I picked up my bag, and then I picked up my whatever, I trekked all the way from Gwagolada into the city, because I was pursuing a job. And I told myself, I'm not returning back to Port Harcourt until this is done. The mastermind. And then I continue, and that works. And when it works, I got that job. And I got it. I started planning on the ministry and all of that. The mastermind does not quit. It doesn't quit. The mastermind will go until answers come. I pray God is giving somebody the mastermind. You will not quit on this journey. I'm not hearing your amen, my friend. I say you will not quit on this journey. You will not quit. Whether there is hungry, whether there is hunger, whether it's working or it's not working. Until you tell yourself it's working, it will never work. Can you hit your chest and say it's working? That thing will work. I say it will work. Oh my God. Your dream must work. It's working now in the name of Jesus. Joshua had a dream. And he developed what we call the mastermind. And that mastermind drove him. Alright. Let me show you from the Bible in Exodus 33. Alright. Look at Exodus 33 in verse 11. And the Lord speak unto Moses. Are you there? How? Face to face. Look at it. As a man speaketh unto his friends, and he turned again into the camp. But his servants Moses, who? Joshua, the son of Nun, a young man. What happened to him? Departed not. Moses finished. Moses left. Oh. Moses went back. He saw Aaron. He saw Od. They have destroyed everything. Joshua, your master has left. He's going back to lead the congregation. Joshua said, no. God spoke to him before he left. He has not spoke to me. I will not go. That's the man with the mastermind. Moses spent 40 days on the mount. Joshua spent 60 days on the mount. That's a man that will succeed. That is a man that will succeed. It's not, amen, amen, you are off. Even personal time that you will use to pray on your own in a day. In fact, the pastor needs to motivate you and motivate you for you to pray. And you want to go, you will go nowhere. Until you have a mindset that can drive you as a person, you go nowhere. The Spirit of the Lord will come into your mind today and it will drive you as a person. All right. Did Joshua ask friends? Answer me. Did he ask friends? Can you say yes? Aaron was there and was he not one of his friends? All those children of Israel that was with Moses, they were they not his friends? Now, did he live like his friends? No, I'm not hearing you. Did he live like his friends? No. There are people that their friends are controlling them. They make them live the life they live. Joshua has a life and he has a mastermind. What mastermind does is it makes you independent. That is, you can define what salvation is all about. Oh yes. You are not living on the basis of what you used to know. You are living on the basis of what the mind says. You understand that this is right. I mean, if you get to Juju house, will anybody tell you that this is Juju house? You don't want to answer. If you meet a wrong pastor, won't you know? No, answer me now. You will know now. Nothing. Your mind will tell you this is a wrong place. For the Bible says, if your mind condemned you not, which means your mind can equally condemn you and tell you, my friend, this one where you are now, this one you are doing now is wrong. Oh my God. Number three, I saw self-discipline in the life of Joshua. I saw self-discipline. He could discipline himself. He could stay and say, look, I go nowhere until I got the voice. As you come to this mount today, God will give you his voice in Jesus' name. If you believe that, give me amen. It was self-discipline. It was not our discipline. It is self-discipline. Your flesh will tell you sex is important. But self-discipline will tell you sex is not important. Your future is more important than sex. And can I tell you something? Good. For their two shall become what? Answer me. Their two shall become what? So if I commit fornication or immorality or whatever with a girl that is possessed with mommy spirit, who am I? Because for their two shall become what? That's the scripture. If I go out with a failure and a failure is my boyfriend, what you call boyfriend ought to be the right word, but today it was lost friends. And then if I go out with a young man that is already insane, then I'm insane already. That's why you lost your studies. Your brain started making mistakes. For the two shall become one. The wife you marry play major role in your life, if you don't know. The man you marry play major role in your life. If I marry a cocaine pusher, if before I know I will start smoking cocaine. For their two shall become what? One. No woman in this world will tell me I don't know what my husband does. Nobody. Even though the man did not tell her, she will know. This is what this man is doing. God will deliver you from strange relationship. You don't want to say amen? I know a man. He took a girl on the side. He was a site engineer. And I was working there. As at that time, I was a tiler. Just a tiler, you know. And as he was doing that and was doing that, he took a girl. And this man was making money. He was doing well in life. As soon as he picked that girl, my dear son, as soon as he picked that girl, bah! He went to the hotel. He finished, come back. The next day, he lost that contract. The second day, he ran into a trailer. Bah! The third day, his life battered. Finally, he died. Let me tell you, be careful. I say, be what? My friend, say, I will be careful. Be careful. Be very careful. All right. How many minutes does it take? How many minutes? if you want to go into sex now, how many minutes does the sex really take you? 15 minutes. If you don't try, now you do 1 hour. If I even see a man, say, or a woman would do 1 hour, say, you go to say the man a dog. How many minutes does it take you? Your destiny is on the line. Your entire life is on the line. Everything is on the line. And what is it just finished like this? Oh my God, why did I do this thing? Why did I do it? Why did I even do it? Why? And when you're saying why, at the end of the month, they say you don't carry belly. And you'll be looking at yourself like this. Say, I don't want my parents to know. You need lies to cover lies. When once you start it, you will be covering it with more lies. More lies. More lies. You tell your wife lies today, tomorrow you tell her lies. You say, you know, as I was coming, the motor app, tomorrow wahala, and I make her stop, and I make her waste time. You're playing yourself. The more you play yourself and get into gold. Joshua wasn't like that. He was a man of self-discipline. Until there is self-discipline, you will go nowhere. I pray that God will give you the spirit of self-discipline in Jesus' name. You see, people, they get to any place like this. When once he gets into the church, he cannot sit down for 10 minutes to hear a message. Because the churches he used to go, after they dance, after dancing, they don't go. No message, no nothing, no word of God. The man would just come up like this, tell story. You know, I enter plane, you know, I saw somebody eat bread in the plane. Is that what we want to hear? Give us Bible. Say Bible. Say it again. Give us Bible. Tell us Bible. You know, hear for story. Number four, we see creative vision. Creative vision. We see a man that sat down on his own and created a vision. He stayed there for 60 days and developed a vision on his own. This period you're going to be here, what are you developing? You can write a book this period now. You can write a book this period. You can produce the best book for these 2 months. Because this is a consecrated time. And you still miss your target. You can use this time and say, God, this is my time on the mount. I will not go out of this step. This is where I'm going to stop. How much you discipline yourself with me determine how much you succeed on the journey. If you don't discipline the way you walk, the way you dress, some of you now can be in a public place, a woman, you walk out, come out like this. Go to throw. Go to throw. You know how to discipline yourself. You know how to control yourself. It's only this generation. You can see a young lady go stay by this fence now. You go open up everything. Even if you wear trousers, you go remove the trousers and stay there. We. Mama, no, when you were born, it wasn't like that. Mama, am I correct? Can you stand up? Yes. Was it so? I didn't know that women used to wee when I was born, when I was growing up. I didn't know women used to wee. If somebody tell me that women used to wee, I won't believe it. Because I've never seen my mother or my elder sister wee before. Today, no self-discipline. Kuku mana, she buy white pint, eh? The old yard go know that they say she buy white pint. You go spread them everywhere. Come and see, oh, come and see. Come and see, oh, come and see. Come and see, oh, come and see. You go. is no privacy again. A woman has only one glory. The day that glory is gone, your entire life is gone. Am I talking to you today? Only one glory. The man where they trouble you today, if he cast that glory, you go call him tired, you not go pick that call again. Has it happened before? Don't put up your hand. But has it happened before? You know it. Number five. I see power of consecrations in his life. In Numbers 11, in verse 28. And Joshua, the son of Nun, the servant of Moses, one of his young men, answered and said, my Lord Moses. What is the next word? Forbid them, forget them. Forbid them, forget them. No serious person wastes time with serious people, with unserious people. Every serious person will never waste his time with unserious people. Moses was busy. As they were giving him trouble, he was busy with them. And Joshua said, Oga, forget them. He knew that he was enough for his master. Can we say that you are enough in this church? Can your mother look at you and say, this one is enough for me? Can your parent look at you and say, this one is enough for us? I know that with this one, I don't need to cry again. He get picking where he go get, he go die quick. He get picking where he go get, that is only one. The more he for die, the more he go want to live more. Because each time you see the picking, your belly go, they switch you. I pray God will make you like Joshua. Can I hear you say amen? Point number two, the man for Canaan. The man for Canaan. In Joshua chapter 1 verse 1, 2. Joshua chapter 1 verse 1. Now after the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord, it came to pass. Can I tell you one good news today? That all those stories are coming to pass. Oh my God, these people are not with me. I say all those things are coming to pass. Your sin is coming to pass. Can I tell you something? You know what it means by come to pass? The trouble came and it passed. The sin came and it passed. The failure came and it passed. So can I hear you stand up and shout, and it came to pass. Say it again. This trouble that has come is passing you. This wahala is passing you. In the name of Jesus Christ. Sit down, sit down. Look at verse 11. Look at verse 11. Sit down, look at verse 11. Pass through the host and command the people, saying, prepare ye virtues, for within 3 days ye shall pass over this Jordan. I thought that these people would say amen to that. To go in to possess the land which the Lord your God give it you to possess it. Now, as you look at the Bible, you see people like Moses, they have come and gone. You see people like Paul has come and gone. You see people like Peter, they have come and gone. In this generation, you see people like Matulita, they have come, they've done it, they've gone. And then you see people like John Wesley, they've come, they've walked, they've gone. This is your own time. What will you walk before you go? Are you hearing what I'm saying? The man for Canaan is the man that must have the following. Number one, must have unwavering courage. Must have a courage that does not waver, does not shake. He must have a courage that continues. Not the courage that this one come today, he has said. Tomorrow, the other one come, he has said. He does not have a stand. Joshua have a courage that have a stand to say, this is my passion, this is where I stand, this is where I die. I die on this. I survive on this. That's a man with courage. Number two, must have what they call self-control. So how to control himself. Number three, willingness to take decisions. It's easy to write plan, but it's not easy to take decisions. Willingness to take decisions. Some of you now, when you come to me, if I tell you no, you say, this man, you know, they help people. But I've told God to give me the power to tell some people no. There are decisions you must take. You're able to look at the person's eye and say, no, this one, I don't agree. No, go walk. Go and do the one that will walk. Until you're able to look at somebody eyeball to eyeball and tell him no, you won't go anywhere. Some people, everything that come, yes. Let me not offend him, yes. Let me not just do this thing. If I do this thing, I ain't go feel, yes. Even when he's dying in the midst of it, he's answering yes. He's answering yes. Be able to take decisions. Number four, doing more than paid for. You do more than you are paid for. You do more than you receive. If you are in the church, you do more than you are paid for. Number five, we see self-made grace. Can I hear you say self-made grace? Say it again. Look up here. If you need to follow any man in life, follow the man who made himself. He start from nothing. He has nothing. And he was able to make himself. If you follow that man that was able to make himself out of nothing, he can make you. Am I talking to you? If you follow a man that has never made himself, how will he make you? He didn't know the road. Somebody need to know the road before he can carry people past the road. Thank God, by God's grace, I know the road. I say I know the road. Praise the Lord. And if I know the road, I can show you the road. For time, take down the scripture so I can look at point number three. We pray now. For time, take down the scripture. In Joel chapter 3, verse 2. Joshua chapter 5, 12 to 15. Joshua chapter 1, 15 to 16. Point number three. The fight for freedom. Joshua fight for freedom. This morning, you, this moment, this day, you will fight for your freedom. I will fight for my freedom. Not longer wishbone is going to now be backbone. The backbone that will help you attain your freedom. You fight for it today in Jesus' name. As you look at all those people of old, Moses, Joshua, all of them, Daniel, they did not evangelize the world. They didn't evangelize this world. It was after Jesus came that Jesus said, go ye into all the world and do what? And preach that gospel. They did not evangelize the world. But did you know what they did? How many of you want to hear what they did? They opened the world. Can I hear you say they opened the world? They opened the world. Today, you will not hear any pastor bringing down the world of Jericho. They have opened it. It's for us to move in. Am I talking to somebody? There is no longer parting of River Jordan. They have parted it already. It is for us to enter. There is no longer Edek. They have done all of that. You don't need to sit down to write a new Bible. They've written the Bible already. Other men has labored. We are to enter into their labor. The road is open now. You can move in and conquer your land now. You can get your freedom now. You don't need to kill yourself anymore. How many persons are ready to fight for their freedom today? If you are there in the house, can you stand to your feet? They have opened the door for us to come in. And I want you today to go to the Lord in prayers. I say, Father, I am getting into my land today. My land where you want me to be. The place where you want me to be. You are going to fight the fight for freedom. And get into that land in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name we pray. Put up your right hand. Say, my Father, my Father. Say it like you mean it. Say it like it's coming from your heart. From this moment, I receive power, backbone to go forward in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray. If you are not praying, you are not helping yourself. Live a life like Joshua. Joshua never depend on his friends. Joshua never prayed the way his friends pray. Even when Moses left, Joshua continued to pray. That is a child of God. Can I see people like Joshua in this house? In the extension there? Everywhere, left, right, and center? Can I see people like Joshua? Who will be praying like Joshua? Who will be consecrated like Joshua? Can you open your mouth and tell the Lord, I receive the backbone to go forward. In Jesus' name we pray. Give me amen. Right now, you had a desire before. You have a dream before. Even from your secondary school, there was a dream you had. There is a passion you have. Can you wave your hand at me? There was a dream you have. There was something you had in mind. Now keep that hand there and make a decree today that you are turning that dream to cities. You are turning that dream to lands. You are turning that dream to reality. Joshua turned a dream of 450 years. He turned that dream to a reality. That your dream is coming to reality now. Open your mouth and turn that dream to reality. Pray now. You can do it. You can do it. Don't keep quiet. You can do it. Do not keep quiet. You can do it. Do not keep quiet. You can do it. Turn that dream to a reality. My brother, will you leave this service and remain the same? My sister, will you leave this service and remain the same? That was what Joshua did. He turned his dream to reality. He turned his dream on the children to reality. He turned his dream on his ministry to reality. He turned his dream that people has had. He turned the dream of his father to reality. He turned the dream of his leader to reality. He turned the dream of his generation to reality. That was what he did. Now, I tell you something. Before you were born, your father had a dream. Your family had a dream. And your mother even discussed that dream with you. In fact, when you married, your husband discussed a dream with you. But since you came into that marriage, that dream has not come true. Now, today is the day that every dream your father died and lived. Listen to me. Moses had this dream. He heard from God face to face. He tried to implement it. He couldn't implement it. Joshua came and take over the dream from him. And he implemented it. The dream of your generation, the dream of your father, the dream of your mother, the dream of your relation that seemed like is dead. Now arise. Take those dreams. Make it work. Pray. Make it work. Go further. Go. You can go. Just look up here and look at me. I want to talk to you. Moses did on the tabernacle for 40 days. Joshua did for 60 days. That was an evidence that Joshua was going to go ahead of him. Can I tell you something today? You must go ahead of your father. And that is why it's called fight for your freedom. Which means, where my father could not get to, I should go above there. Can you lift up your hand and say, my father, from today, I go ahead of my mother, I go ahead of my generation, pray now. Go ahead. They bought one car, you can buy three. They built one house, you can build 20. They own an estate, you can own a nation. Go ahead of them. They have PhD, you can have professor. Where do they stop? Don't stop where they stop. Joshua never stopped where they stopped. He went ahead. Moses stopped for 40 days. Joshua stopped for 60 days. He doubled it. You can go. It's not time to go. It is time to go ahead of your people. In Jesus' name we pray. By God's grace, the Lord has placed me as some Moses. And as some Moses. You will go ahead of me. I say, you will go ahead of me. If I go to rapture tomorrow, if the Lord call me to glory, one glorious day, this ministry will not die. You will go ahead in the name of Jesus. You'll be strong. You'll be wonderful. Every Jordan before you will part in the name of Jesus. I want you to put up your hand and say, my father. What stopped my father? What stopped my mother? What stopped their generation? Cannot stop me. I command you, die. Open your mouth and command the power that stopped them. That thing cannot stop you. That power that stopped them cannot stop you. That demon that stopped them cannot stop you. Pray now. Something stop your elder sister. Something stop your elder sister. Something stop your mother. Something stop the people. There has been a story. You are breaking down those stories today. That thing that stopped it will not stop me. Will not stop you. Will not stop us. Fight for your freedom. Fight for your freedom. Fight for your freedom. Fight for your freedom. You don't keep quiet to fight. All those deity in your family, all those territorial spirit, all those things trying to stop you, stop you, stop you, stop you, stop you. You get to a place everybody will hate you. That is not of God. Command that devil to get out of your life. Command that Satan to get out of your life. Command that power to get out of your life. Few minutes to go. Few minutes to go. Few minutes to go. Pray now. Few minutes to go. Few minutes to go. Few minutes to go. We don't have time. Deal with them before we round up. Deal with them now. Deal with them now. See that thing. See that thing. See how your mother married a house problem. That thing has come to you again. See how your mother married and there was nothing to offer for. That thing has come to you again. See what has happened before. Are you repeating story? Are you repeating story? No way. No way. No way. I'm not going to repeat history. I am born to break history. I am born to scatter history. I am not born to receive and to repeat history now. Come on, break down those history now. In Jesus' name we pray. You're here now. There is a particular time people used to die in your family every year. Somebody must die. That particular time, put up your hand. You're here now. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Right now, put up that hand there. Put up that hand there. Right now, I command that history be broken down in the name of Jesus. From that henceforth, that history stopped. I say stop. I say stop. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we want to thank you today. Everybody lift up your hands. We want to bless your name today. We adore you today. And Lord, we magnify you today. For we know that you've given us backbone. With this backbone, we are taking over the land. I say we are taking over the land. With this backbone, we are taking over the sixth continent of the world. With this backbone, we are succeeding in the name of Jesus Christ. All the witches and all the thinking, I'm going to do it, I'm going to do it. All of that is expiring today. And Lord, we are rising into action. And Lord, we are going to take action in the name of Jesus Christ. Whatever it costs us, we will take action. Whatever it will take, we will take action. And Lord, we pray as we take our action, results are coming. I say results are coming in the name of Jesus Christ. I declare today, every history that has followed you, every monitoring spirit that has been following you, by the anointing of God upon my life, every chain they put on your neck and put on your waist, by the power and by the reason of the anointing on this altar, I command that chain cut down in the name of Jesus. I blind the eyes of those devils following you. I blind the eyes of those demons following you. And I declare you free. 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 in the name of Jesus. Every contamination you have received through immorality, through any medium, any way they have initiated you before, anywhere your blood is right now, any devil sucking your blood and your destiny, I command that Satan vomit it now. Vomit it now. In the name of Jesus. Any challenge in your life, you're dead, you can't hear, I command you hear now. You're here, blind, you can't see, I command you see now. And I declare any sickness, any disease in your body here, go, 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 in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for answering this prayer. For in Jesus' most wonderful name we pray. And everybody give me a loudest amen. Thank you.